The curious history of A, B, and why C rules the PC. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I get from time to time. Why is there no A colon or B colon? It just seems odd that Windows default drive is C, even when it's the only drive. Okay, this one's really just for fun and a little bit of history. Those who have been using computers for more than a couple of decades will actually know this tale, but I did get asked it again the other day, so I thought I'd capture the response for posterity. It's a decades-long story. Disks used to be floppy. The existence of a hard disk implies the existence of a soft disk, right? And indeed, the first disks used with PCs were flexible disks in protective cases known as floppy disks. The most common capacity was 360 kilobytes. Honestly, it would take dozens of these to hold a single high-resolution image today. Subsequent floppy disks were smaller physically, though they had greater capacity. And even though they were encased in a protective plastic shell, the media inside was still that same floppy magnetic material. And indeed, the original personal computer, the IBM PC, had at least one and usually two drives into which floppy disks could be inserted. At the time, floppy disks were the only storage available. These two devices were designated, you guessed it, A colon and B colon, respectively. Now, even the largest capacity floppy disk was no match for the hard drive. The smallest internal hard drive, 10 megabytes comes to mind, not quite one high-resolution photo even yet, was at the time a huge amount of space. The floppy disk drives, A and B, remained. The new hard drive became the drive C, the third drive in the system. Now, floppies more or less stagnated in size, but hard disks continued to grow. Soon enough, floppy disks were more of an afterthought, and the hard disk took on the role of primary storage device. When Windows and other larger operating systems came along, they installed to the first hard disk because they needed the room. Thus, drive C became the system drive. Now, current machines no longer have floppy drives. Variety of reasons, their small size, the appearance of other media like CDs, DVDs, USB sticks, and other things, they've outlived their usefulness. But the hard disk remains, and it remains C. Here's the catch. Even though the floppies are long gone and drives A and B are no longer in use, C remains the system drive. It's just baked into too much software that makes that assumption over too many years. To suddenly attempt to say call it drive A would have probably dire consequences for any software that could never conceive of it being anything other than C. So, C it remains, even if it's the only disk drive on your machine. Now, there's really nothing special about the letters A and B. If you don't have floppy drives, well, you could use them if you want for something else. For example, using the Windows Disk Management tool, you can assign them to represent other existing drives. Since drives can only have one letter at a time, you may need to unassign an existing drive letter to assign that drive to be A or B. And, for the record, don't try to reassign C. If it works at all, and it shouldn't, it's a recipe for disaster. If not immediately, then on your next reboot. So, that's why we start with C. If you're running low on drive letters for some reason, you can always bring A and B out of retirement. For updates, for comments, for links to related topics and more, visit askleo.com/180707. If you've got a question, a simple historical question, or a problem you're facing right now, visit askleo.com/ask. If you're interested in signing up for my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, where we cover topics like this and security and problem solving and more, visit askleo.com/newsletter. And if you'd like to chip in and help keep Ask Leo on the air, visit askleo.com/patron for options. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.